Hello there. Today we're going to be wiring up this basic 3-volt LED circuit with a switch. This video's for David Lacey out there. Sorry for the long wait. So I'm just going through the items that we need here. So I just showed you a battery holder, which will hold a CR type battery, CRTO2032. And we had a switch there, LED. In the 3-volt range, so we won't need a resistor in this video. So this is just a basic video showing how to wire a basic LED light. I'm just showing you the materials there: solder, there's some heat shrink there, battery holder, LED. There's our wire strippers. Just testing out the LEDs there with the 3-volt battery. You can run 2 3-volt LEDs off of the battery, but that will drain the battery, so it's probably advisable to use 1 3-volt LED to 1 3-volt battery, as we got there, the button battery. So just stripping the ends of the cable there. So you've got red and black, so red's gonna signify the positive and black the negative. So strip back the ends, and they're twisting the wires together just to make it easier to put some solder onto the ends there. So I'm just putting them in my little helping hands tool with a crocodile clips, as you can see, which is very handy. Got the soldering iron there, all warmed up and ready to go. That's a 30 watt soldering iron. And now we're just putting some solder on the ends of the wires. So put the soldering iron behind the wire just to heat up the copper wire, and just put the solder into the ends of the wire there. And we'll connect this to our battery holder. I'll also solder the terminals on the battery holder, and then we'll solder the ends together, the cables to the battery holder. So just snipping the ends off after the solder has gone hard, cooled down. Try not to burn yourself while you're soldering. Just cutting the ends off neatly there with a pair of wire cutters. And now we're just going to put some solder onto the terminals of the battery holder. It might be a neater job to put the battery holder onto a piece of circuit board if you want to. Depending on your project, it'll certainly make the circuit more sturdy. But in this case, I'm just soldering the ends straight to the battery holder. So there we are, just joining the cables to the battery holder, making sure that we've got the negative on the negative side of the battery, and of course the positive on the positive side of the battery. We'll be switching the positive side, so when we get around to putting the switch in, it will switch the actual positive side of the circuit. So that's switching the red cable, which will then go into the LED, the anode side of the LED, which is the positive side. The negative side of the LED is the cathode. So there we are, we've got that in place. And we'll put some heat shrink over the terminal part of the battery holder and over the exposed metal of the cables, so that'll add some protection and avoid any possible short circuiting. So I've got a bit of heat shrink there, we'll put that over the cables and then we'll use some heat to shrink wrap the heat shrink over the cables and the terminals. You can use your soldering iron But I've used a lighter in this video, cigarette lighter, which reminds me I've got to give up smoking. So there, I just sort of going over with the end of the soldering iron there just for demonstration, but it's easier with a lighter or one of those little flamethrower things. What are they called? I can't remember what they're called now. You obviously don't want to be burning your cables or items, components, so you just want to lightly put the lighter over the heat shrink quickly, just until it shrinks. So now we're getting the LED in place. In this case, it's a yellow LED, stripping the cables back again where we need to strip them. And there's a little diagram on the screen there showing an LED, the plus and minus, and the anode and the cathode. So we've got an actual picture of an LED and a circuit symbol of the LED, also showing the anode and cathode. So anode positive and cathode negative. Not sure if I already mentioned, but you probably can see we've got the circuit diagram for the whole thing at the top left hand side of the screen. So there we are, just tinning the legs of the LED. We'll do the same with the cables, which we're going to join to, using our happy hands-free or helping hands thingamajig there. So making sure that we've got the red positive joining to the anode and the black negative joining to the cathode. If you get it round the wrong way, it won't work. So carefully does it. And cut the ends off just to make a nice neat job. So when we join the wires to the LED here, we've just got one basic circuit without a switch. And we can test to see if our LED circuit will work without the switch. Once we know that, we can proceed and cut into the positive cable to put our switch. So heat shrink again. So I'm putting heat shrink on the negative cable there, as you can see, and attaching the negative cable to the cathode of the LED. So same again, use a lighter to activate the shrinking properties of the heat shrink. Oh no, we haven't got to that part yet. I'm just testing out the circuit. So there, there's a basic circuit, just testing the circuit with the battery there. So as you can see, it's working, so we can proceed to put the switch in place. Yeah, I remember now, I put the lighter on the two heat shrinks now after cutting into the positive cable where we will put our switch. So they are using the lighter there carefully, as not to burn any components in the wires. And there's some nice protection for our circuit, so as to avoid any potential short circuits. There's our cut in the positive cable. And we'll strip the ends back. Same again, strip the ends back, twist the wires together. And we'll put some solder on the ends, same process. Applying the solder. to the ends. Been a bit late getting some videos up this month, been a bit ill, had sunstroke, and I caught a virus as well, so only just getting over that. But I don't want to moan. So put some heat shrink over the cables there. We've split into the positive side of the circuit to put our switch. Trim the ends up with the cutters there, the side cutters. And now we're getting our switch ready. In this case, there's three terminals on this switch, and we'll only need two terminals, so you definitely want the center terminal and either side, either of the other two terminals will be okay to switch your circuit. So start on the outside there, just putting the solder on the outside terminal. And solder on the middle terminal, and we'll just discard the other terminal as we won't be needing that. So one wire in one end. The other wire in the center terminal. So like I say, as long as you use the center terminal, you can choose which other terminal you're going to use for switching. Doesn't matter. But you must use the center terminal on this particular switch. So now just trying out the circuit with the switch in with our battery. And there we are, lovely jubbly. So that yellow LED is working and the circuit is working with the switch. So we can move on and use that heat shrink. We'll put the lighter onto the heat shrink and we're nearly finished with the project. So there's a heat shrink on the terminals of the switch. And again, we'll use the lighter to activate the shrinkage. And that is job done. So of course you can put these lights into your craft projects or whatever you want to do with the light circuit. You can extend the wires if you want to. You know, use as much wire as you need to cater for your projects. And there we are. As you can see, battery through the red cable into the switch, out from the red cable into the LED, out of the LED into the negative cable and back to the battery. And that completes the circuit. And now I'm just farting about, seeing what we could do. So I'm using the eyeball just as a demonstration. Just had to close the curtains there, make the room a bit more dark. There we are, eyeball, lit up eyeball. I've got this resin thing, I don't know if you can see it picking up there, but I want to do like light up the cracks in resin casts. And there's a silly little project I did with an old roll-on deodorant. And you can see the switch is in place there, so the switch is screwed into the container and the circuit is inside the container. There's actually two LEDs there operating from 2 3-volt batteries. So that was just a fart around, sort of mock experiment, and there I'm just messing around with that LED we've just made. There's another project I did, there's a video on the channel on how to make one of these LEDs as well. This is using different types of LEDs, the strip LEDs. and that's around a piece of acrylic. You can use ordinary LEDs like we just did in the video, which we just made in the video, to light up acrylic engravings. And there we are. Basic LED circuit with a switch. So I hope you enjoyed, and thanks for watching, and see you soon.